Hi there, all you happy saps. It's your Scully boy here, Kevin the Skull Anderson. And right now, I'm giving you an opportunity to live the God life. Not the good life, but the God life. The life that God wants you to live. All right, you ready? Okay.
Cue that beautiful intro, motherfucker.
Right, so we're right like dogs. Okay. So, as you can see here, I've got myself a bag of broccoli. Currently thawing out. It's almost thawed out, by the way. You wanna know how I got it to thaw it out? Well, it's real simple. I filled a pot up with steaming, scorching hot water. But before that, I put the bag of broccoli in there. And what I did was, as I was filling the scorching hot water up in the pot, I made sure to shower the bag as well. Of course, it had to be closed, so I kept it closed, because that's how it came in. So, I left it on one side for about 10 minutes. Then, I turned it right around, poured all the water out of the pan, or the pot, or whatever, and I flipped it on the other side, and I'm not talking about the pot here, because that would be stupid. That would be selectively retarded. Basically, I filled the pot back up with scorching hot water with the bag sitting on the other side while still in the pot, apparently. So, same thing here, 10 minutes, covered up with a lid, and look what we have here. Y'all, man, we got lots of shit going on here. Ain't nobody gonna give a if it's right or not. Shh, man. But as you can see, the more water it has, the better. Because that's how you know you're doing it the God-like way, right? Because the hell with everything else. And hell is not for heroes, it's for villains and antichrists and whatever. But you pretty much get it now, don't you? Now, considering that it's all the way thawed out, it just makes sense to conclude that there's more than one way to cook this. You can store it, you can put it on the stove, you can microwave it. I think it's pretty simple, don't you? Yeah. And on that note,
let's get to the bones of the pond, yeah.
Hey, buddy, it's that old disrespectful New Yorker here with a special pack of Zipa. Because that's all you need to live a nice, clean life is a bunch of Zipa.
Sir, can you do me a favor?
Yeah, what would that be? Quit sucking the donkey stick, Van Dyke!
So, of course, you have to let all that water seep out of the bag after you open it. But you gotta leave it open just slightly to let the water out so none of the broccoli will get out, right? So it just makes sense. It makes perfect sense. It makes perfect sense. It makes perfect sense. So much sense. And then, of course, you put the broccoli sans water in a bowl. And then, of course, you open it up. I mean the microwave, that's what I mean. You open the microwave up. Close that king door, put it on for a minute. And I'm not even an expert of anything in any field or subject or anything. But it doesn't take an expert to teach you guys the that you need to know. Right? I mean, it's just common sense here, isn't it? It's just common sense.
It's common sense!
But anyway, all kidding aside, let's just get straight to the point here. I'm gonna tell you how it is. I'm gonna show you how it is. And let me tell you right now, you're not even gonna regret it. Not a bit, you're not gonna regret it. Because if you do regret it, you're gonna get the biggest freaking kick in of your entire life. I'm just kidding, just ignore that last.
Oh no, the freaking Lockley's done.
So anyway, you open back up this thing after you cooked it for a minute. And I mean, you open up the microwave after you cook the broccoli for a minute. Take a nice big taste test. Mr. Food on WFMY News 2. He has his own segment at noontime during the noon news at around 12:20-ish called Mr. Food's Test Kitchen. You should go ahead and check it out.
Sure.
That's just complete sarcasm, right? Oh, and here's another funny thing that I discovered.
There's a little bit of sweetness in every song you sing.
Al Jolson, but you know what's funny? Take this into consideration. Just really do. Really dope. Take this into consideration. You know, there's a dishwasher that's readily available for every home.
Because it's modern life! Cause you can't go wrong with modern life!
Actually, you can. But you know what I'm saying, so it's all good. Point I'm trying to make here is simple. If you're gonna make a dishwasher full of dishes, everything you do, you gotta make sure that you put some dishes in it. Cause that's what my friends tell me to do when they're away and I'm keeping house for them. I mean, it's actually quite simple, isn't it? It's so simple, you could even say that it's easy as taking a big, fat, all-over Grand Canyon Square. Nah, I'm just kidding, but just forget what I said. It's not gonna make sense anyway, because most people are gonna take their wrong way, and shit's gonna happen, and everything's gonna hit the fan, and nobody knows what's gonna go wrong. Because reasons! And you all know what these reasons are now, don't you? Anyway, it's your boy Scully here, reminding you straight up. There's only one way to live the good life, and that's by living the God life. I'll talk to you. Wow.
Public service announcement!
Alright. So let me just get straight to the point. And I'm gonna tell it to you. Very simple. So, you don't want to spend $1 a month joining a club for men that shave, right? Well, you're in luck because I've got just the video for you! Dollar Shave Club for men somewhere online, really all you would have to do is go to a local Walgreens, buy yourself some of that Barbasol shaving cream, and a 4-pack of triple blade razors that cost about $14 to $15, depending on where you want. And then of
course, you have to apply shaving cream on yourself and stuff like that. And then you shave yourself. And the next thing you know, if you see that your razor is getting clogged up with hair, all you have to do is something that's quite simple, actually. It's very simple. Just rub water over this. Hot water. Like boiling hot water. Not really boiling hot water, but steaming hot water. As opposed to a steaming hot pot of shit. You know what I'm saying? Like a steaming hot pot of shut up! But anyway, all you gotta do really is just go to a local Walgreens and stuff and buy yourself some shaving cream and a 4-pack of triple blades. Shave yourself with shaving cream on you, and if you see that your shaver's getting clogged up, just run some hot water over it on the front and back of it. And if you do this every 2 days, like I do, you should find your razor lasting a hell of a lot longer than you. I'm Governor Small Anderson. You've been my loyal subjects.